Well, 2022 is almost over and I thought I should share some of the best open source applications with you. The applications I try to cover in this video are fairly new and offer some incredible features. I hope you enjoy this video and maybe try using these applications in your Android device. So, let's get started. We are going to start this video with an incredible file sharing application called as Photon. This is a cross-platform application, so you can transfer files between Android and Windows. The transfer speed is extremely good with this and there are no advertisements and no trackers. So it is definitely better than those crappy file sharing applications you find on Google Play Store that have like lot of advertisements and lot of trackers. You can transfer multiple files at once and the UI is extremely minimal. And most importantly, you can transfer files using a hotspot, so Wi-Fi is not that important here. The base file size of this application is very less for both Windows and Android, so it should help you in saving some storage as well. If you have heard about Owlbot Dictionary, at number 2 we have one simple and open source client known as Owl. This application lets you input any word to get the definition along with examples or even emojis and pictures of the word that you type. You also get the pronunciation of the word, both phonetic and the audio, using TTS. This application supports Material U design on Android 12 and above, and it also lets you choose between different TTS languages. It is a very handy tool if you are trying to learn different pronunciations of words and there are no advertisements, so you get a distraction-free experience. Next up, we have an application called as Todon't. It is like a reverse to-do list that can help you take a good look at your bad habits and how you are able to manage them. It can be as simple as eating too much sugar or drinking less water. This application lets you jot down all the bad habits so that you can work towards a better you. It has a very clean log page that will let you take a look at the habits avoided so that you can start with a fresh morning every day. Both the light and the dark modes are supported and this does not consume much storage in your phone and is a very useful application if you are on the way to give up some of your bad habits. Well, if you have any bad habits. Next up, we have Open Calculator. Well, this has to be one of the best open source applications available out there. If you don't like the default calculator or Google calculator in your phone, then you cannot go wrong with this application. It has a great interface and lets you do all the basic calculations or even some advanced ones. It also supports Material U theming and you can also take a look at your history. It is free, open source and has no advertisements or trackers, so it is definitely worth checking out. Now, the last application for today's video and I had to save the best for the last. You might have come across a lot of application managers for Android, but this one is different. It is called as InYour App Manager, and if you are looking for application managers for your Android device, don't go looking for anything else, just download this application right now. It is stylish, informative and is completely free and open source. You can do a lot of stuff with this application like getting the list of applications present in your phone, which is like the basic functionality. Now if you click on any application, you get the application permissions, activities or trackers, which is the most important function related to security. You can also directly launch, delete, share or extract the APK files. Well, that's not it. You can also take notes or perform batch functions like deleting, sharing or extracting. One important function of InYour App Manager is that you can install APK files through this application. That is going to give you all the details before you install the APK file. So this is an all-in-one tool for your Android phone and is extremely useful as well. You might face some small bugs here and there or the application might crash sometimes because it is the early version. Other than that, you should be good to go. So that was all about today's video and I hope you guys enjoyed this. I have some other videos on my channel, particularly for open source applications. You can go ahead and take a look at those videos as well. And if this is your first time on this channel, please make sure you hit the subscribe button and turn on channel notifications so that you get notified whenever I post a new video. Thank you so much for watching. Stay safe and take care.